Over the past 30 years, and despite substantial declines in the raw gender pay gap, the residual gender pay gap in the US has stagnated at around 10%. In other words, if we compare men's and women's earnings after netting out factors such as education, years of experience, industry, and occupation, women persistently earn 90 cents for every dollar earned by comparable men. At the same time, there is increasing evidence that women have lower salary expectations than men, and this is especially true at the top of the income distribution. To what extent are these phenomena linked? If women have lower salary expectations, this can give rise to an ask gap. Women may demand lower salaries relative to their male counterparts, potentially contributing to the gender wage gap. This paper studies the role of the ask gap using data from Hired.com, a leading online recruitment platform. This is a real-world, high-stakes setting. The site serves as a job board for full-time engineering jobs, with a focus on the tech sector, and the average salary on the platform is $120,000. Importantly, the site's recruitment process allows the author to track typically unobserved components of salary negotiations. First, candidates create a profile containing standard information from their resume, and, crucially, an ask salary. This is their answer to the question, what base salary are you looking for in your next role? Firms then view these profiles, including the ask salary, and send interview requests to desired candidates. These messages typically contain a basic description of the job, as well as a bid salary. This is the salary at which the firm would be willing to hire the candidate. Interviews are conducted outside of the platform, but Hired.com records whether an employment offer is extended and accepted, as well as the final salary. Using data from over 120,000 unique candidate profiles, 43,000 jobs, and nearly 7,000 firms, the author investigates whether a gender ask gap exists in this setting, and to what extent it affects the bids and final offers received by candidates. To start, this figure plots the distribution of male and female ask salaries in the data. While both have a similar shape, the female's distribution is shifted to the left. On average, women ask for nearly $7,000 less than men. Of course, while this may be indicative of a gender ask gap, it could also reflect differences in resume characteristics, such as job title or experience. Thus, the author estimates a residual gender ask gap after controlling for the numerous factors listed in candidates' resumes. And she finds that, starting from the raw ask gap and then controlling for these characteristics, still leaves a statistically significant gender gap. Women ask for 3.3% less relative to men with comparable resumes. In dollar terms, this is a difference equivalent to over $4,000 per year. The size of the gap varies across different subsamples, and, in particular, increases considerably with work experience. While the gender gap is essentially zero amongst candidates with only 0 to 4 years of experience, it expands to over 6% for candidates with over 20 years of experience. These results establish the existence of a gender ask gap, but does it affect firms' bids and final offers? This figure plots the distribution of bid salaries received by candidates and reveals two notable patterns. First, the female's distribution is again shifted to the left, suggesting there is also a gender bid gap. Second, and more importantly, the shape of the bid distributions is strikingly similar to that of the corresponding ask distributions. Firms appear to closely follow candidates' asks when forming their bids. And, in fact, the author estimates there is a raw gender bid gap of 3.4%, which falls to 2.4% after controlling for resume characteristics. Further controlling for candidates' ask salaries eliminates the gap entirely. Put another way, Women on the platform receive bid salaries that are lower than those received by men, but this is almost entirely explained by the fact that women ask for lower salaries. Correspondingly, while the residual bid gap is larger for candidates with more experience, further controlling for differences in ask salaries completely eliminates this pattern. The ask gap also explains nearly all of the gender gap in final salaries, and there is no evidence that women are discriminated against on other margins, such as receiving fewer bids or offers. Finally, the author evaluates a 2018 policy change that affected how ask salaries were solicited. Prior to the change, candidates were asked to fill in an empty field. After the change, this was pre-filled with the median bid salary received by comparable candidates over the past 12 months. These figures show that providing individuals with this additional information eliminated the ask gap and rendered the bid gap insignificant. This is mostly driven by women asking for higher salaries after the change, and it doesn't appear that firms penalized this behavior. Post-reform, there was no change in either the number of bids women received or in the time it took them to receive one. Thus, this paper shows that, in this setting, the gender ask gap contributes to pay inequality, that a simple policy change can eliminate the gap, and that women are not penalized when they ask for more. These results highlight the important role of the ask gap, though further work is needed to explore these dynamics in other settings. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. These include many papers on gender inequality in labor markets, research on gender differences in negotiation, and finally, work exploring how information transparency affects job searches and salary decisions.